you can see, I am no stranger to mountain bike pads in general. I have different types of pads for different styles of riding. But when I go out for my normal 98% typical type of riding that I do, all right, welcome back, party people. Today we're going to talk about mountain bike protection, specifically elbow and knee pads. If you're an extreme downhill rider or enduro rider, this video is not for you. This is meant for all around mountain biking. So take that into consideration. All of this information that I am providing today is basically my opinion over about 1,000 hours on these Alpine Star Paragon pads. As you can see, I am no stranger to mountain bike pads in general. I have different types of pads for different styles of riding. But when I go out for my normal 98% typical type of riding that I do, I always fall back to these Alpine Stars Paragon pads. They offer the best amount of protection and the best ventilation for the style of riding that I do most. So I'm gonna talk about all the good things about these pads and all the bad things about these pads and why I actually replace these pads and what type of pads I actually replace them with. And maybe this will help you make an informed decision whether these pads are right for you. So let's get to it. First, I love slip-on pads versus the Velcro pads. The Velcro pads tend to weigh more because they do have these Velcro enclosures on them. This is a hybrid pad, so it has a Velcro enclosure on the top and it has elastic on the bottom. But for me, these pads tend to bunch up around the Velcro, and somehow the Velcro always ends up rubbing up against my leg or my arm and kind of giving you a rash. So I tend to try to stay away from these for most of my normal riding. The other thing that is great about these pads is you can see the stretch fabric here as it stretches. You can kind of see through the fabric, so it does offer a good amount of ventilation. Not the greatest amount, but it offers a good amount of ventilation behind the knee and behind the elbow here. There's always a trade-off on how much protection you get versus how much ventilation you get. Okay, for most of these slip-on pads, around the upper here is this silicone strip. As long as this silicone strip is making contact with your bare skin, these pads will stay up. So that means this pad should be your base layer. So if you plan on wearing long pants, you need to make sure that this pad is actually under your pants. This silicone strip needs to make contact with your skin in order for it to work properly. All right, so we're gonna flip this around and I'll show you the lower part of this pad. So if you look at the inside of the lower part of this pad, you'll notice there is no silicone grip strip. Now, some people don't like the fact that this pad doesn't have that silicone strip on the lower. And as a matter of fact, a lot of pads that are slip-on like this don't have it. However, I actually find this to be a bonus for two reasons. The first reason is the pad's actually much easier to get on your leg, to slip over your leg. And I also find if you don't have that silicone grip on the bottom, what tends to happen for me is that this bottom part here cuffs up under the pad. And that gives me a little bit more ventilation than it normally would if the pad was stretched further down the front of my leg. All right, so you notice too that even after almost 1,000 hours of use, these pads look almost new on the outside. So this fabric here is very easy to clean. All it takes is some soap and water, and you can just kind of wipe the surface down here after your rides. Now, Alpine Stars does not recommend that you actually submerge these in water, so you got to keep these out of the washing machine. All right, one thing to note about these grip strips, typically they're made out of some kind of silicone or other type of rubberish plastic. If you get rashes on your legs easily or allergic to silicone specifically, you probably want to stay away from these particular slip-on type pads that have this kind of grip strip on it. These pads come in at about $55 US for the knee pads, and I think they're similar for the elbow pads as well. So some great value. The styling is great here. You can get different colors. The logo here, you can get red, so there's other colors, and even there's an option now where it's kind of blacked out as well. So pretty comparable to other pads in the segment from other manufacturers. So I really like these as my all-around everyday pads. All right, so now that we went over some of the good points about this pad, I'm gonna tell you about some points that I dislike about these pads. First of all, with these particular pads, when you first get them, you need to do a break-in ride. When they come, the padding here is fairly hard, and until you get a sweat break-in and get it to conform to your shape of your leg and your knee here, they seem a bit awkward. So you want to try to get one or two break-in rides for these to really kind of conform around your leg. So don't expect these to wear extremely good when you first get them. You'd really need to break them in with a couple of rides. All right, so one of the other downsides to these types of slip-on pads is obviously you have to take your shoes off in order to slip these on. So if you're a rider that likes to kind of be dressed for the ride before you get there and you don't want to take your shoes off in order to put your pads on, you probably want to look at the double Velcro closure type pads that split in the back. The other thing I'll have to mention, and this holds true for most of these type of slip-on pads, there's really no protection in the back of the pad. So you get this stretching material in the back here, and it's pretty much like wearing a sock. It's not gonna give you any protection if you take a hit on the back of the leg, but that's something you have to kind of weigh when you're looking at pads. Now, these pads do stretch. I would say probably after 10 or 15 rides, these pads start to stretch. So both the openings of the pads start to stretch. So you need to take that in consideration when you're looking at sizing. So I'd say if you're on the cusp of a size, for example, maybe you look at Alpine Star's website and you do your measurements and you're on the cusp of a medium or a large, I would say go with the medium, the smaller size. So the other thing I mentioned too is Alpine Star's recommend not to submerge these pads in water. Yes, I know you're gonna sweat, you're gonna ride through streams, you're gonna get these wet, but they don't recommend you throwing these in the washing machine. So that's another downside to this type of pad is you're gonna just have to do a clean on the outside here and call it a day. So this is the main downside. So I've had these pads, like I said, since October of 2017. If you can see here that the pad has actually split. So the pad inside is perforated across here. And after 2 years of use, basically the pad has kind of ripped in two. And so what you end up here is you've had this piece of pad on the bottom, you have this piece of pad on the top, and you have zero protection in the middle there. And this would be covering, like, for example, the middle of your kneecap. So if you took a fall on pads that are separated like this, basically they're going to offer no protection because they're just going to pry open and your knee's going to be susceptible to injury. So after about two and a half years, three of the four pads have actually separated. Both of the knee pads have actually separated here, so you can see how easily these fold over. And one of the elbow pads have actually separated too. All right, so I have turned the knee guard here inside out, and you can see here that the pad is actually stitched into the guard itself. So there's really no way to replace the pad individually. All right, so that's some of the good things and some of the bad things I like about these pads. Now, since I have three of the four pads that are basically useless now, and pretty much you have to replace the whole guard itself, I had to make a decision to actually purchase new pads. So now I'm gonna share with you the pads that I chose to replace these with, and are they any better than these pads? So I chose to replace these pads with, yep, you guessed it, another pair of Alpine Star's Paragon pads. And these are the Paragon Plus pads. So I think they are a little bit longer than the other pads. So we'll do a quick comparison here, but I did end up going with the more stealthy, it's almost the logo almost blends in with the black here. It's a kind of a dark gray or silverish color as compared to the yellow that I went for. And I think this is actually new for either the 2019 or 20 season. So you can see these compared here. So let's compare the new version of these pads with the older version of these pads. And then I'll also give you some recommendations on how to help extend the life of the actual pad in this knee guard. Remember I said three of the four had actually split along this perforation here. So I do have some recommendations that will help extend the life of these pads. All right, so I have the older pad here on the left and the newer pad here on the right. As you can see, the fabric on the newer pad is much longer than the older pad. And I really like that. It's probably a little bit warmer and probably weighs a little bit more, but I think the coverage you get on your arm goes all the way up and it kind of blends in with the shirt that you're wearing as well. Whereas sometimes with the older style elbow pad, I would have some bare arm in between the pad and the shirt. Okay, again, I have the older knee pad on the left and the newer knee pad on the right. And again, you can see there's more fabric on both the top and the bottom. And like I said, this gives you more coverage on your leg. It kind of blends in with your shorts. Sometimes with the shorter pad here, your shorts would ride up and you would have that bare leg between the shorts and the pad. And this longer pad here really eliminates that. And just for reference, these are the same size pads. I wear a size medium in the Alpine Stars Paragon. So both of these pads are size medium. The one thing I noticed in the newer Paragon Plus pads here, you can see here at the top, there's actually the pad sewn in, but the top is actually left open. So it looks like you could slip this pad out here and actually replace it individually. Now I have not followed up with Alpine Stars to see if that's possible yet, but it looks like they may at least be thinking toward actually individual pad replacement. All right, so what's the trade-off between the older pads and the newer pads? Obviously, we have more fabric, so if I had to guess, I would say the older pad is actually lighter than the newer pad. So let's put both of these on the scale and see what the difference is. This is the older Alpine Stars knee guard here. So that comes in at 134 grams and 4.75 ounces. All right, so let's put the new knee pad on. All right, so let's put the newer knee pad on the scale here, and we're coming in at 4.85 ounces and 137 grams. All right, we'll do the same thing for the elbow pads. This is the older Paragon elbow pad. All right, this comes in at 4 ounces and 114 grams. All right, let's do the same for the new Paragon Plus elbow pad. So it comes in at 4.75 ounces and 135 grams. All right, so the results are in. So let's take a look at the results for the knee pads here. And if we take a look at the old knee pad, it came in at 4.75 ounces, 134 grams. Whereas the newer Paragon Plus knee pad came in at 4.85 ounces and 137 grams. That is a grand total difference of 0.15 ounces or 3 grams. So there you have it. The new Paragon Plus knee pad is slightly heavier than the older Paragon knee pad. As we move over to the elbow pads here, the old elbow pad came in at 4 ounces or 114 grams, and the new elbow pad came in at 4.75 ounces and 135 grams. So that is a grand total difference of 0.75 ounces or 21 grams. So elbow pads, once again, the new Paragon Plus with the additional material came in at 0.75 ounces heavier or 21 grams. All right, so just a few recommendations on how to extend the life of your pads, and these come from both personal experience and also from reading through the care and maintenance tips. First of all, after every ride, you want to hang your pads up to air dry, and you want to make sure that you do not hang your pads up by the opening that has the silicone strip. So turn them upside down and hang the pads from the bottom opening. That ensures that you don't pinch or wrinkle or actually separate the silicone grip from the upper opening. The other thing you want to make sure that you do is not store these with something heavy on top or bend the pads when you stow them. If you bend these pads, they will tend to wear and start to separate. All right, that'll do it for this video. Hope you enjoyed the content. If you did, like, share, and subscribe. Make sure you have your post notifications enabled. You know what to do. Until next time, skill up and ride.
Van up and go.
Just have fun.